Region 1 was loaded with powerhouses, maybe more so than any other region in the state. But hardly ever did you hear the words Sergeant Central become associated with such powers. That was reserved for teams like Hankinson, Sheldon Chaffee, Oaks, and Lisbon. But here the cadets were, playing in the first round of the Region 1 tournament. They opened with scrappy Hope Page, led by All-Stater Eric Pilgrim. The cadets, though, proved the theory that one person does not win games. It takes a total team effort, and the team from Sergeant Central pulled out a tough first round win. Up next, the most anticipated game of the tournament, Sergeant Central's Region 1 semifinal with Lisbon. The Broncos had defeated the cadets by just 2 points the week before. Certainly, revenge would be a factor. Sergeant Central got another great team effort, but it was Jeremy Berg sinking a shot with time running down to give the cadets a 1-point lead. Lisbon's desperation attempt at the buzzer was no good. Sergeant Central, in the upset of the tournament, advances to the Region 1 title game.
I was just thinking we finally got Lisbon. You know, it's been 7 years waiting, and it's finally there, and it was worth the wait.
Sergeant Central met Oaks for the right to advance to state. The Tornadoes had beaten the cadets twice during the regular season, but by a total of only 4 points. This, too, was another tough battle, but only until the fourth quarter, when the team everyone least expected to go to state did just that. Sergeant Central was on its way to Bismarck with a 66-50 win.
I'm still kind of in a dreamland. It hasn't really hit me yet.
It was an exciting time for Sergeant Central and the entire community. In fact, it had been 14 years since they last experienced the thrill of going to state. The cadets won it all back in 1979, and wouldn't it be something if they could duplicate that feat in 1993?
We aren't going to see anything we haven't seen before. You know, we've seen all, you know, the best, some of the best big guys in the state, and some of the best guards and best shooters in the state. You know, we're not going to have any surprise when we go out there. And there's no pressure on us, I think, is what we like about it. We're just supposed to go out there, we're not supposed to win, you know, just take it like we have all the way.
Well, yeah, we definitely got used to playing tough games. We lost 8 games during the year, but every one of them was close, and we could have came out on top out of any one of them games. So we know what it's like to win in pressure situations.
Most of our games were 2-, 3-, 4-point ball games, so you know, we're ready to play, and the kids are excited about going.
A lot of people are thinking, well, we're just happy we made it. We're not. We want to make it a great one.
The cadets opened with one of the tournament favorites, DeLax Burlington. They were led by Mr. Basketball candidate Steve Holan, a 6'4 forward, averaging 30 points per game. But Sergeant Central controlled the entire first half. Defensively, they kept Holan under wraps. Offensively, they could do no wrong. During one stretch in the first half, the cadets even led by as many as 11 points.
Jeff Bussey inside the free throw line scores. 4 Sergeant Central players have scored in the first quarter. Gwynn, rather, is left wide open, and wow, what a start for Joel Gwynn. 10 points already. Relax, Burlington continues in the man-to-man defense. Siebert got low underneath and scores off the glass his first field goal. 3.6 seconds, so there's plenty of time for Sergeant Central to get a pretty good shot off here before the half.
So the way Sergeant Central has passed, and which in my opinion is the best thing they've done so far in this game.
Gwynn. Oh, it nearly went. Well, that would have been almost fitting considering the first half that the big guy has had. Joe Gwynn and Sergeant Central leading DeLax Burlington 36-27.
But the shots that were falling in the first half would not drop in the second half. And Mr. Basketball candidate Steve Holand came alive in the second half, showing everyone why he's up for that award. Sergeant Central lost their state tournament opener. It was a hard-fought battle, especially hard to take immediately following the game.
I don't know what happened. When we practiced here, this side of the gym was hurting us. Couldn't hit nothing. Go down there and hit everything. I don't know what it is.
Sergeant Central could now do one of two things. They could lay down and die and say it was just great to be there, or they could bounce back and prove that the state tournament was where they belonged. The cadets chose to do the latter. Sergeant Central beat Garrison in the next game and then met Gackle Streeter for fifth place on Saturday. It wasn't the title game, but you would not have known, judging from the cadets' effort. They went on to take fifth place in the state, a remarkable finish and one that Kim Marks' crew and the entire community can be extremely proud of.